So Moses, you identify her needs. You sacrifice yourself. You lay down your life in order to meet her needs proactively and intentionally. That's love. And not only are you loving Ashley, but you're actually loving God because you're in obedience to him when you do so. To love Ashley is to love God. And Ashley the same. To see Moses for the man that he is. To look at what he needs in his life and to be there, to lay down yourself, to sacrifice yourself for him as an act of love for God, not just for Moses. Because marriage is going to get hard. And you don't want to be just relying on your love for Moses. You want to be relying on your love for God. And you want to rely on your love for God as the lead and the guide for you on how you love one another. If you want to love God, you love one another. Marriage is an example of a heavenly relationship. It's an earthly example, but it's a relationship that God created in heaven. So in Ephesians, Paul says, "Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her." And so Jesus demonstrated what this relationship was like. It's about mankind and the church being married to Jesus. That marriage between man and God are coming together so that we can all experience the power and the perfection of love. And so this marriage today is a symbol of that. The two of you are becoming one, you're loving one another, and you're a demonstration of what Jesus came to do on earth. You're an example of a heavenly relationship, a heavenly marriage. It's a union of two people, but beyond that, it's a union of two families, two communities, two friends, two cultures coming together to demonstrate the love relationship that God has with his people. And so that's what we're here to celebrate, the love of the two of you coming together. So I'd like to take this time to make a statement symbolizing you guys' relationship and your commitment together. Moses, do you take Ashley to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you promise to love and cherish in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better or worse, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her for so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Ashley, do you take Moses to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise to love and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better or worse, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him for so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Now I know Moses and Ashley also have their own vows they'd like to share with you, or with each other.
Dear Ashley, on this day I take you to be my wife, my partner in life, but long before you were a thought in my mind and a feeling in my heart, you are, and always will be the daughter of God. From the moment I heard your voice, before I even caught a glimpse of you, I was drawn to you. You are passionate and loving and inspire me to dream bigger and become better. I remember the day I asked you to be my girlfriend and you said you needed time to pray and hear from the Lord. Those were the longest days of my life. Days that I cherish now because at that moment I knew I had found the one my soul loves. Firstly, I want to say thank you for trusting me with your heart. I know it was a scary leap for you, but you trusted the Lord, and look where we are now. I've been really struggling to write this because I have no idea how I'm supposed to fit why I love you and choose you within a couple of minutes. So Here's a couple of reasons. You have the biggest heart of anyone I've ever met. You are beautiful, intelligent, and powerful, dedicated to everything you set your mind and hands to do. You constantly go out of your way, even when it's at your own expense. You have never lost your childlike awe of the world and people, seeing the best in others, leaving love, peace, and joy everywhere you go. You love the Lord, giving yourself to serving Him even when it hurts. You have a beautiful voice. Please, anyone, everyone, she has a beautiful voice. And through the hurt and struggles, you've never given up, and the Lord is making you ever more beautiful. Thank you for being my inspiration when hope was lost. Thank you for being my focus when I am scattered. Thank you for being my emotions when it is hard to feel. Thank you for being my anchor. Thank you for being, for loving Pandora and being a safe place for her. That means a lot to me. Thank you for making every day brighter. Thank you for holding me to the highest standard before God and man. I want you to know how privileged and blessed I am that even with all my imperfections, you still choose me. Our marriage is a calling, and I will answer that every single day. I don't know what it is ahead of us, but seeing all the tests that we have gone through to get here, I know we can survive anything. So as we enter this covenant with God and in front of our family and friends, I vow to submit in reverence to Christ. I vow to love you always and without hesitation give my life to protect you. I vow to lead you as Jesus did. I vow to respect and love you as I do myself. I vow to be one with you, making decisions together, not excluding you, not being selfish, but being in unity with you. I vow to be transparent with you and always show you emotional intimacy, to communicate about everything. I vow to listen to you when you're talking.
That's a lot.
You get my undivided attention. I vow to love you unconditionally, which means there isn't ever a condition where I don't love you. Life will certainly bring along obstacles and enemies, and I will be there looking out as your husband to protect you. I vow to be strong in the Lord. Only from Him my strength comes. With all I have, everything I have, I vow to keep us in His presence. I choose you, Ashley. I always will choose you, and I love you.
Well, that's not hard to follow. Okay. Moses Ondeche, I love your kind and tender heart. I love how you always believe the best in people, and you believe the best in me, even when I can't see it myself. I cherish your vulnerability, your desire to serve and please the Lord, and your willingness to own your mistakes and never stop growing. I love how you make me laugh, even though I'm supposed to be the funny one. It's like a contest now. You push me closer to Jesus every day, and I thank you for that. You are everything I ever asked the Lord for, and you are a million things I never knew I needed. And I love the way that you care and love for your daughter, Pendo. I know that our journey is not going to be an easy one, as it hasn't been at all. But regardless of the mountaintops we climb or the valleys we walk through, I only want to do it with you. I promise to be there to lift you up and encourage you as you pursue what God has for your life. I promise to stand beside you, to support you, to listen to you, to serve and honor you for all my days. It is my honor to love Pindo with everything inside of me. And I promise to call out purpose in her and throw courage on her like confetti every day. I promise to be a safe place for her to be free and flourish. I promise to always make you great coffee every morning. I promise to always let you kill all the bugs and all the rodents and all the things that shouldn't be in the house.
Thank you.
I will never try to do that. I promise to try, this is the key word here, try and learn the rules of football and not just cheer when someone scores. I promise to try to keep the kitchen drawers organized. It's also a try keyword there. And I promise to let you make and keep whatever organization you want. I will let you do all of it.
Good.
I promise to pray for you and speak life over you and our marriage and our family. Moses, thank you for loving me intentionally and with such care. Thank you for protecting me and growing with me every day. As long as there is breath in my lungs, I am yours completely. I am excited and ready for the journey and the privilege of being your wife, and I love you.
Wow. So now we're going to exchange the rings. The ring is a symbol of this love and this union. It's a circle because it's never ending, and it's precious, just like their love. And so we're going to exchange these rings as a symbol of that never ending love, that living in love and that life together that brings you in unity with each other. And it's also the basis of our relationship with God. And so now you're uniting yourselves to one another, and you're already united with God. And so now together as a family, you become an instrument of the Lord to use in this world for his glory and honor. So Moses, place the ring on Ashley's finger and repeat after me. Ashley, I give you this ring.
Ashley, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment.
As a symbol of my commitment.
To love you as your husband.
To love you as your husband.
And to live in love forever.
And to live in love forever.
Now, Ashley, place the ring on Moses' finger and repeat after me. Moses, I give you this ring.
Moses, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment.
As a symbol of my commitment.
To love you as your wife.
To love you as your wife.
And to live in love forever.
And to live in love forever.
Now, as they're becoming united together as one, we also wanted to take this time to recognize their union with God. And so Moses and Ashley are going to take communion together to symbolize and to recognize the communion they both have with the Heavenly Father and his Son, symbolizing the death and burial and resurrection of Christ. And so as they do this, we're going to play some music. A song called Jireh that speaks about the completeness of God and that he is all that we need, and he's more than we need. And the totality of our relationship with each other and with him can be satisfied in him alone. And so we'll play that song while these two take communion and symbolize that union they have with God and celebrate the union they are gaining with one another. So during this time, feel free to pray and or sing along or just check your own life and see where you stand in your relationship with God. Maybe you need to restore your relationship with Him and celebrate your communion with God during this time. So let's take this time to celebrate.
Be clear, I'm no Ashley.
I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice carried in the rhythm of those. You had crossed in my right now.
Sing with me. We'll sing Jireh.
Jireh, and you are enough. Jireh, you are enough. Jireh. You're forever enough, always enough, more than enough. Forever enough, always enough, more than enough. I don't wanna forget how I feel right now. On the mountaintop, I can see so far. Jireh, you are enough. Jireh, you are enough,
and I will be content.
And I will be content in every circumstance. Jireh, you are enough. You're forever enough, always enough, more than enough. You're forever enough, always enough. I'm already loved, I'm already chosen. I know who I am, I know what you've spoken. I'm already loved, more than I could imagine. And that is enough.
Sing that again, I'm already loved.
I'm already loved. I'm already chosen. I know who I am. I know what you've spoken. I'm already loved, more than I could imagine. And that is enough. I'm already loved. I'm already chosen. I know who I am. I know what you've spoken. I'm already loved, more than I could imagine. And that is enough. And that is enough. And that is enough. That is enough. So I am enough, sing Jireh. Jireh, you are enough. Jireh, you are enough. And I will be content in every circumstance. Jireh, you are enough.
Not us, sing that.
If he dresses the lilies with beauty and splendor, how much more will he clothe you? How much more will he clothe you? If he watches over every sparrow, how much more does he love you? How much more does he love you? If he dresses the lilies with beauty and splendor, how much more will he clothe you? How much more will he clothe you? If he watches over every sparrow, how much more does he love you? 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 How much more? It's more than you ask, think, or imagine. According to his power working in us, it's more than enough. It's more than you ask, think, or imagine. According to his power working in us, it's more than enough. More than you ask, think, or imagine. According to his power working in us, it's more than enough. More than enough. It's more than you ask, think, or imagine. According to his power working in us, it's more than enough. It's more than enough. It's more than enough. It's more than enough. Jireh, you are enough. And I will be content in every circumstance. Jireh, you are enough. And I will be content. And I will be content in every circumstance. Jireh, you are enough.
Let's all stand together and pray a blessing over this couple. Heavenly Father, we stand before you today to celebrate your children. And as your children, as witnesses to the union of Moses and Ashley, Lord, we ask you to bless their marriage. That you, with the power of your Holy Spirit, would guide Moses to know and to understand the needs of Ashley. and that he would be given the grace to meet those needs proactively, intentionally, each and every day. That he would be guided by your Holy Spirit to see needs that a man would not normally know or understand, but that it was through your power that he loves Ashley. And Lord, I pray for Ashley that she would see Moses through the power of the Holy Spirit, and that she would know and understand how to meet his needs so that she could love him in the greatest way possible. That as they love one another, Lord, they just rain worship down and in praise of you and love for you, Lord. That when Moses loves Ashley, that he's loving you, Lord. And that when Ashley is loving Moses, that she's loving you, Lord. And that you would just bathe them, Lord, with your love, with your grace, with your faithfulness. That they would be blessed in relationship with you. And that they would be a uniting force in their families together. That two families are coming together, two groups of friends, two communities, two cultures, Lord. And we know the difficulty of marriage. We know the difficulty of this work ahead of them. But we know, Lord, that you didn't need it to be easy, but you wasn't a burden. That they could love one another with your strength, with your power. And that they would be united with one another in love, and that they would be united with you in love. And that their families and their communities would be united together in your love as well. Lord, we just pray that when people see the love of these two, that they would see your love in this world. We just pray that you would bless them. In Jesus' name, amen. Moses and Ashley, in the presence of all of these witnesses and under our Father who loves you both, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Moses, you may now kiss your bride. Now I have the unique privilege and opportunity to introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Ondeche.
People are asking for you, not me, it's the people. All right, a round of applause for the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Ondeche, and the bridal team. And of course, let's celebrate Jonathan for taking us through a nice ceremony. Brilliant. Now, a couple of announcements, okay? To my extreme left, once we climb up the stairs, to my extreme left, where the lovely people are in some nice dashaki outfits, we have some nice drinks for you. So look at your neighbor and say, we have something for you. All right, so once we are done here, after Jonathan makes the final prayer, we shall, in fact, I think we shall all go out with that song, yeah? It's a nice jam, yeah? So once you are done and Jonathan makes the final prayer, we shall move out with that song, enjoying ourselves, go get some nice something, and then I shall come back and be able to tell us what is happening next. We shall be having some photos, but we shall do them a bit later on. So, sounds good? All right, over to you.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time. We thank you for the opportunity we have to celebrate together, and just thank you for all these people who've come to witness an example of your love here on earth. We just thank you for this opportunity, and we just pray you'd bless this time that we have together, bless this food, and we just pray that you'd we would have a wonderful time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. DJ, drop the beat. Let us move to the cocktail area. As the music is playing, let's move to the cocktail area. And that will be a good thing. DJ, let's do this.
As I kiss you again and again and again and again. Now everybody.